Based on a study by Statista, there are more than 2.4 billion mobile gamers in 2020. And this number is projected to grow by 2.7 billion in 2021. So game development is becoming prominent day by day. And it's high time that we harness these opportunities and start developing our own games. But the question is, how do we start? There are already thousands of amazing game development softwares out there having their own physics, own configuration, own settings and whatnot. But it's always a good idea to start small and grow big. That's why I'm targeting Facebook Instant Games in this tutorial series. Facebook is the gaming hub for about 800 million monthly users. This 800 million includes people who play arcade, RPGs, FPS and a large variety of instant games. These are simple HTML based games which are generally hyper casual and are super easy to play. One major obstacle for game developers is advertising. No matter how good your game is, if people don't know about it, they can't play it. Fortunately, Facebook provides excellent tools to advertise your ad revenue system and advertising campaign, so you can focus completely on the development and the ideation aspect and let Facebook take care of the rest. So in the upcoming tutorials, I'll teach you how you can create and deploy your own Facebook mobile game purely using HTML, CSS and JavaScript, which later on you can share with your friends, family, girlfriends and whoever you want. Prerequisites for this course are absolute none, but it'll be good if you are familiar with some kind of programming language. Other than that, I'll be going through all the basics of game development, dynamic level generation, sprite sheet animations, efficient scoring systems and whatnot. And all of that using a very simple yet powerful JavaScript library called Phaser. I have tried to cover all the intricate details behind the code, but in any case, you get stuck somewhere or you're having some general dev-related doubt, feel free to comment down below, or you can also join my Discord channel for any other queries.